So, it looks like Kate Middleton is stepping down on a temporary basis or a permanent basis. I don't understand what is going on, but they're calling it vacation mode. Thought she'd been on vacation for 6 months, guys. Hey guys, it's Marab Morali. Hopefully you guys are doing well today. Back at again with another video. If you have not subscribed, click that button. It is daily and consistent content. Comment down below and give this video a thumbs up. I would appreciate it. And let's get into this Kate Middleton mess. Three top stories in regards to her in the past 24 to 48 hours. So it's been revealed that Kate Middleton is going to be stepping down from public working engagements for the remainder of the year because she's going on a summer vacation mode. While Kate Middleton's appearance may be her last for a very long time, In the Style is reporting. So are several other articles. What time is it? Well, for Kate, it's summertime because apparently the princess is officially on vacation. Following her standing ovation receiving Wimbledon appearance, royal sources reveal that Middleton is now on summer break and will be taking a pause from public engagements for a while. Now, Vanity Fair also echoed this by stating that they are going below the radar and, you know, going to vacation. Other insiders added that the family will not be traveling abroad, but do plan to join Charles and Camilla in August at Balmoral in Scotland. Now, this is very confusing to me because has she not been on vacation for the last 6 months, been at home, been on bed rest, making sure, you know, with hospital, chemo treatment, if that's what's going on, preventative chemo treatment, but she comes back, returns, and gets a standing ovation at Wimbledon, and then suddenly her work is done. And I just think that this comes across as very bitter, and to me it's very odd, because if you're fit enough to go to Wimbledon and watch a tennis match and hand out trophies to the winners, then you are fit enough to work and attend public working royal engagements. I don't even see Elizabeth or Princess Anne or even Camilla at this point retiring or stepping down for the remainder of the year after receiving one form of standing ovation. And if anything to me, this just comes across as quite lazy. I'm confused. You are the queen to be. Why are you suddenly stepping down to go on vacation? It's been reported. Also, furthermore, how can you go on vacation if you're getting preventative chemotherapy treatment? As far as I'm concerned, people I know that have had cancer and attend grueling chemo treatments aren't going to Ibiza the next day. So I don't understand how they both work, unless one is a fable and we're being fed different narratives and stories, because it doesn't make any sense to me. It's quite odd that now she's stepping down for the remainder of the year. We're not going to be seeing her. And a lot of people also don't like this conversation as well. Even the UK press, somewhat, you know, TV shows on Channel 5, they were discussing this. And there was one lady on the panel stating how it is quite bitter and quite comes off weird. You know, she's there getting standing ovations for just returning to watch a tennis match. Can you imagine cancer patients suffering, struggling, watching that in the hospital beds, going through significant, grueling, painful chemo treatments, losing significant amount of weight, stage 2, 3, 4, and don't have the medical experiences, money, facility, environments, anywhere to go, and they are suffering as hell, and they see someone like her doing stuff like this. It's going to be very bitter and it comes across very wrong. Like, okay, I'm not a fan of Camilla and Charles, but at least they were going to visit cancer centers and treatments and talking about it. Kate would rather go to a tennis match, get a standing ovation, hand out a trophy, and then suddenly she's like, I'm on vacation mode, I've done everything I need to do. As if you work hard anyways, when you definitely don't, and you haven't been for the past 6 months anyways. You've been on bed rest, you've been at home. So why are you now suddenly going below the radar and, you know, disappearing and stepping down? It seems to me that there's something else going on behind the scenes. To me, it also looked like that, you know, Kate attending Wimbledon in all smiles and happiness. Like, to me, it looks like she won the war against William. Whatever was going on between her and William, I feel like Kate wants this marriage, whereas William does not. And I feel like Kate will do anything to maintain it and stay in it. And I feel like she won whatever what was going on. And we know that there's been multiple issues between them, and even Charles has got in between them and etc. to kind of maintain the status quo of what was going on. And I feel like she got what she wanted. But, you know, the UK press clearly aren't liking this to an extent, not the entire. But people over there, I'm surprised in the UK are speaking out about how her standing ovations and returning and suddenly then taking a vacation comes across very bitter for those who are suffering from significant cancer treatments and going through significant pain from losing their loved ones, and how she gets scot-off free in this way. It just comes across as very significantly upper class privilege mentality attitude, we're better and superiors, much like that independent article has said that, you know, that she is naturally just superior to those who aren't. It's just really insane and sad to see stuff like this going on. as far as I'm concerned, she can't be that ill if she was at Wimbledon trying to get her sister Pippa to meet the winner, and then, you know, an ovation took place for him and he had to walk away and she wasn't able to link them both. If you're playing matchmaking, if you're playing introduce my friends, I'm pretty sure you're doing okay, let alone handing out trophies. If she's that unwell, she will not be seen anywhere, point blank period. She would be resting in bed, but, you know, suddenly seeming refreshed and, you know, doing stuff like this, to me, is just very bizarre. And it seems like people are upset about it. And I can see why. Why wouldn't you go to cancer centers? Why wouldn't you, you know, raise awareness for those suffering from cancer, those who are less privileged than you? Why wouldn't you go through these angles and discuss this to a significant level? Maybe she'll do it in the future, but when is that going to be? She's now stepping down and going a while for a while and on vacation mode. It's the fact that it's on vacation mode and on holiday when she's been bed resting and at home for the past 6 months and hasn't done anything anyways. This isn't an ordinary woman we're talking about. We're talking about the queen to be of the royal family. The royal family that spends our tax paying money on their frivolous parties when there are nurses and doctors that should be paid and teachers that should be paid and, you know, all paid towards her. King Charles just bought a brand new house in New York and you have William doing these tea parties with Kate left, right and center, daylight robbery, laughing in our faces. So these aren't ordinary people. We, our taxpayer money funds their lives. So we have a right to ask, where are you going now for the next month, for the remainder of the year? You're stepping down. Like, what is going on? The standing ovation to me and her receiving that and etc. Look, it was nice to see her getting an applause, but it's very bitter for those who are suffering from significant cancer. And my empathy is with the working class. My empathy is where people don't have enough. People are suffering. People are poor. You know, the background that I come from, not my sympathy with the royal family who are $1 billion empire. Why am I going to have sympathy for billionaires who've stole from multiple countries and steal from us as taxpayer money and buy stuff in front of our faces and laugh in our faces? Why would I have any empathy for them? I don't understand why people would want to have empathy for them. So, you know, the video of her and Pippa is hilarious as it is, but her stepping down to me is very confusing and people are also not liking it. They're just really upset. I've seen people's comments online and those who've been very avid fans of Kate Middleton feel kind of betrayed. They feel kind of upset. They feel kind of neglected. They feel kind of confused, you know, lack of guidance and how the whole thing that this was dealt with in the past 6 months from December to now, I feel like we've also been gaslit to make us think really bad for her when that really wasn't the case. And even I, in so many who weren't major fans of her, were worried for her, concerned for her, what was going on, the fake Mother's Day photo, was she taken, she hasn't been seen, XYZ. And at the end of the day, they were just laughing in our faces. Rich billionaires who steal from us and take our taxpayer money to fund their lavish lifestyles, laughing in our faces. I don't understand how anybody can ever be a pro-royalist and want these people and a monarch and etc. when all they do is a lavish lifestyle and they don't deserve any of it. They are daylight robbery thieves. And I feel like stuff like this is annoying. You're on a break, bro. You've been on a break. She's going to be on a pause from public engagements. What engagements was she going on? I would really like to know. What public engagements? Standing on a balcony for 20 minutes is not a public engagement. What public engagements was this woman going to? Like, I just don't understand. But this is what a lot of people are speaking about, and it is quite heated, and I understand. I think it just doesn't make any sense to me. Maybe you guys disagree with me. Maybe you guys agree. Do subscribe, comment down below, and give this video a thumbs up. I would appreciate it. I'm doing a London meet and greet event. The link is in the bio below. Buy your tickets, free food, drinks, and PR goodies. It's going to be amazing. Do subscribe, comment down below. Just let me know what your thoughts are on this. Yeah, and I'll catch you guys soon for another Royal Nugget.